I think. Oh, hold on. Move it slightly. Okay. I think we're good. I've only been doing this for so long. Hello there. It's been a minute. Yeah, I haven't done a video like this. So give me a second here. I'm gonna be very unprofessional. Before I get to the topic at hand, right? I know some people Before I get to the topic at hand, I know a lot of people aren't going to be terribly happy with my decision, but as a preface, just know that I've given this a long time to think about. Gone through all the details, the mental widgets, you know? And I'm perfectly okay with the outcome. Okay? That being said, mental health. I'm so focused on my camera because I got this cool little doodad here with the fade, with the opacity, blurring. God, you could tell I was brought up old fashioned. I don't know half the stuff that I use, and I use it on a day-to-day basis. All right, mental health is going to be an important focus this upcoming year. Okay, 2023's. Right around the corner. I'm shocked that this year went as fast as it did. Like, to me, minus the temperature issue, okay, it's finally getting colder. I'm very happy to say we're getting chilly again, okay? But minus the temperature, it still feels like the summer for me. Like, I do not feel as though we have exited June. But here we are on the cusp of a new year. And I wanted to go in with a very interesting mindset. And so, in order to get this done, I have to take a few steps before the year has begun, okay? The title of this video should say enough. Simply put,
I want to disappear.
Okay. Let me rephrase this, okay? Don't worry, this isn't anything you should be concerned about. Rather, this is a, like I said, it's a personal challenge that I would actually like some people to even try themselves. And if you can, please do. But hear me out. Hear me out, okay? You ever see a link, like a news article, and heaven forbid, you get through the first like couple sentences and you get that pop-up that says, you know, hey, you can't read me unless you sign up for our news article weeklies or you give us your email and your first and last name to read this article. That's the only article you read off that website ever. Have you ever had a friend in high school that was like, hey, you know, it's Saturday evening. We don't got any homework. Let's play some games online. And you haven't talked to the guy in like 8 years. So, but you still have your account open, right? And you haven't touched it in ages. You don't know your username, your password, nothing. But you still get notifications for it on your email, right? That's me. Whenever I check my emails, yes, plural, email, at the end, okay? I know, I'll get to that later. I'm absolutely met with a bombardment. An absolute war zone of messages from sites that I barely go on. Some of them I don't even remember logging into at all. Let me see here. It wasn't IKEA. I think it was Baron? I don't know. I think it was Baron's. It's to the point why I don't remember which one it was. Yeah, it was Baron's. Yeah, it was Baron's. It's a little website. I got an email from a company called Barron's. And I didn't realize, as I was going through my email, I didn't realize how many emails they have sent me for years. I don't remember ever signing up for this website. Oh, no, there it is. Yeah, Barron's. It's an email for Barron's. I don't remember this company. This fall, look forward to the future with expert investment advice you can just trust from Barron's. For the tech industry to shifting fossil fuel demand, prepare your portfolio for what's ahead. Subscribe today for $4 a month. I don't remember ever asking. Yet here we are. Let me go ahead and type in Barron's, right? And here we are. is this the earliest? Yeah, this is the earliest email that I have from them. Barron's, from September 9th, 2016. I have been getting emails from this company for years, and I don't remember ever signing up for them. And that's a problem, okay? That is a problem, I have to admit. Anyways, most of these I don't even check, so they pile up for pretty much eternity as unread messages. And it gets a little ridiculous, okay? It's come to a point where from looking for a single email, I'm scrolling through hundreds of unread emails of advertisement and like company excerpts and notifications and updates, etc., in order to read what I'm actually purposely looking for. Why am I wearing headphones? I do finally sit down and delete maybe a few hundred to a thousand emails. Yes, you heard that correctly. For people who are on our Discord, you might have seen an image that I popped up of where, yes, that is exactly what you see. That was taken as of this recording. This was last night. I told you, I have a problem. So you get the picture. And like I said, that's one email account. I hate to admit it. I do not have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 emails. I have 15 email accounts throughout Yahoo and Gmail, and I think even AOL. If I'm not mistaken, I still have an AOL account. I'm not even joking. I might even have an SBC Global email still active, because I remember using that back when I was a kid for a Lego website. With the amount of emails that I have that I never check, because at this point in my brain, it just registers as spam at this point. It's all, eBay. Here's the latest 50 listings of this item that you looked for as a birthday gift 3 years ago. Here's 50 more. McDonald's, here's a nice, buy 40 chicken McNuggets, get diabetes for free coupons. There are messages from Walmart I don't need to hear, because I already work there. I don't need to know the latest thing in Black Friday sales, because first of all, I'm at a neighborhood market Walmart. We don't have Black Friday. We don't have a buy one sack of potatoes, get one free. No. We don't have a buy a pack of carrots and get the next one half off. We don't have any of that. I can't speak. With all these emails that I have to go through on a daily basis, that I don't go through on a daily basis, flashback to the 44,000 emails on one account. That's a lot of bulk. Not just on my email, but in my life. Moving forward, I want to change that. All jokes aside, I've come up with a plan. Okay. Again, some people will be unhappy about this, and I apologize in advance, but this is for me. I've come up with a plan to leave most of my online accounts, mainly social media, and I'll get to that later as to why. With the last with how the last couple of years have gone, I see myself gradually and unintentionally just abandoning sites that I'm on. Or just straight up being distracted by others, right? And I want to take some action towards that for a little bit of my own personal mental health and for my own personal growth. Easiest way I could say it. Now let's get into the nitty gritty. So what am I leaving? First thing, okay, I don't even have to think about this. The very first thing I'm leaving, this is the one that's going to kill off a lot of happy out there. Facebook, it's gone. I'm done. I have been on Facebook for years. I started a Facebook back in high school, way back in the day. I fairly even remember the day I got it. I think I was at the library. And I got a Facebook account. And so I've had that for long, about a decade. Oh God, I'm 28. That moment you try to remember when you got your Facebook account, you realize it was more than 10 years ago. I barely even log into the thing anymore. Okay. Apart from grabbing an old photo or two to show someone, family member, coworker, a picture of my grandma, or a picture of the guacamole that I made a couple years back, whatever they want to know. Oh, how spicy is it? And you show them a picture of, like, every pepper you can buy at a grocery store on a table. But yeah, not a whole lot has pushed me away. It's almost the same thing as everything else I use, honestly. Admittedly, the biggest thing that has pushed me away is the drama, negativity on the platform. Oh my God, the negativity. Ads, like crazy. The spam accounts, right? Like, I'll be scrolling through, and I showed this to one of my roommates. I'll be scrolling through Facebook. This is, now keep in mind, I'm recording this a couple days after Thanksgiving, right? So you would think that I would be seeing a bunch of Thanksgiving dinners, thankful for the raise I got at work, or grateful for the family I have, or grateful for this eggnog that I am chugging to the end of the earth. I get two pictures and one post for Thanksgiving, and scrolling for about 2 minutes is nothing but ads and videos sponsored by companies. And I didn't actually realize how bad it was until I sat there in front of him, scrolling down, and he saw it for himself. Just how many, well, I'm talking the Dodo, New York Times, advertising for a new VR set, Amazon stuff, meme videos, which I don't have a problem with. But if I want to see, you know, one of my cousins sitting down for a nice meal, or one of my coworkers saying how their day was, that's what I'm on Facebook for. I am not on Facebook to scroll through a bunch of prank videos, buy two get one free pizza deals, unless it's Domino's, of course, or, you know, Christmas miracle videos are cool, I guess, for this time of year. That's cool. I'm not on the platform for that. And another problem is, I get distracted by these. So as much as I want to complain about all these, I'll be on my bed, you know, throughout the night, an hour before bed, scrolling through all of them. And it's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. There's another issue a couple years back. I'm not going to name any names. I'm going to keep them anonymous because I was raised to have a modicum of respect for anyone, whether or not they were a friend or a foe. And on my side of things, I've really been the only person to actually show that any form of respect. And those sorts of people found that they really had nothing better to do with their time and their life than to stalk my accounts, harass me, spam me, taunt me, flaunt their desire to make me generally unhappy, and try to flare up this love little thing called PTSD, which mix that with depression, and you got, I don't want to talk to no one. So, as much as I love Facebook, to be able to connect to family and friends, my social battery is at a constant 5%. Okay, I work retail. I'm a customer service representative, among other titles. And I'm dealing with people on a constant basis. Anywhere between 5 to 8 hours a day. Once I get home, I'm preparing one of a few things, which ultimately leads to, you guessed it, socializing. So, yeah, straight up the back, Facebook, I'm sorry, but that's going. Sometime very soon, as to that, I will get to that later on in the video. What else, though? Well, you'd be surprised at just how many accounts I'm connected to on the World Wide Web. So far, I've only mentioned Facebook, and you're watching this video being hosted on YouTube, so that's another one. But I'm also on Twitter, with 3 different accounts. I have, in total, 5 YouTube accounts, and one on the way. I have Twitch, I have Discord, most game-related console-esque sites like PlayStation and Nintendo. I have 4 main Google accounts. Can't tell you how many Yahoo accounts I have. 20 plus, I think we're at like 23 Gaia Online accounts throughout the years. A DeviantArt account that I haven't touched in years. Somewhere out there, I believe my MySpace still exists. Want to feel old, I think my Zynga. I have 2 Wish.com accounts. I have Amazon, eBay, Trello, RPG Maker Games, RPG Maker Forums, KH13, KHVids, Steam. I don't know if Dizzler still exists, but I have one of those. EA Games, Wayfair, Michaels, Brandless, TradePub, Etsy, food accounts like IHOP and Subway, my personal being Domino's Pizza. I can't tell you how much of my paycheck has gone to that. Thunder Valley Casino, which I haven't really actually done anything with. I've been to Thunder Valley probably like 5 times in total throughout my adult life. Restaurant.com, which I haven't touched since I first logged in back in apparently earlier than 2019, because that's the earliest email I have, and it's not the thank you for signing up with us email. So I have no idea how long that account was created. I have Quora. I have a Reddit. I have something called Zenva, which I don't even remember, but apparently I have an account for, I guess. I have a account called Yur, Y-U-R. I have an Uber account, which I haven't used in over 1/2 year because buses are cool, and I just don't really like going places. Game FAQs, I have an old account on there. I think it was originally called Twofold Pain. By now, I probably changed it into something or other Bowtie Artist. Walgreens, which I don't even remember walking into in the last decade, and I still have an account from them. I have a Blizzard account. I have a Blizzard account, despite the fact that I've never actually sat down and played a Blizzard game in my life. I have an AOL account. Are you serious? Oh my god, I just realized. Yeah, I still have my AOL out there somewhere. I think I have an Earthlink account. Oh no. Oh no. I mentioned SBC Global earlier and Earthlink. Oh geez, do I have a Netscape? Oh god, hold on. I can't tell you how often in the past that I have gotten the your email account is getting full. Please move some stuff into the trash, or else you won't get emails message. I can't tell you how many times I've gotten that, and I kid you not. I actually had to... I'm going to admit something here. I actually had to buy extra storage for my email, which almost no one does. For people who don't know, for your Google accounts, if you meet an exasperated amount of storage use on your Google account, you can purchase an extra amount for the month or for the year. I think I added an extra terabyte, which is the only reason why I'm still getting emails off of one account. This is not including the rest of the accounts that I have. The 15 emails that I have. Only one I've expanded. Okay? I have a problem. And I want to solve this problem. Recently, I was in a cleany sort of mood. Some of you know that I recently got a bit under the weather, a bit ill. And I'm not one to just sit in bed. I did sleep a lot, but one of the other things I did when I was starting to get on the healthier side of things is I just started throwing a bunch of stuff away. I've had a lot of stuff growing up and a lot of stuff moving in and out of places. Stuff that I just don't need. Or things that are broken and one day I want to fix, but I never got around to. Or the traditional, you know, somebody might need this. Somebody later on might need this, you know, USB, like, A to B adapter, and, you know, I'll be able to be the one to give it to them. Just torn clothes that I might put a couple extra stitches on one day, but never got around to 3 days later, or 3 years later. Just... my closet was a mess. My paperwork was a mess. I had paperwork from years ago that I didn't even open that no longer applies nowadays. Pamphlets that I never got around to reading for years. Kept saying I should. Never did. Essentially, a lot of memories to parts of my past that I just need to finally let go of. That being said, being that I was cleaning out my closet, it then struck me, I think it's time to clean out my life. I haven't actually mentioned what I'm staying at yet, okay? With so many accounts I'm finally getting ready to go through and delete, I haven't gotten to the positive side of things. What am I staying on, no matter what? Right off the bat, that simple, Discord. For those of you who have been living under a rock for 10 years, or still using a compact tower Windows 3.1 DOS computer. Discord is a multi-tool of communication, from voice calls to video calls, to building communities, sharing files, annoying everyone with pictures of funny-looking cats, and it is accessible through your computer or your mobile device. Best of all, it's free. It just occurred to me, I really don't know what this does. There's my problem. I use Discord to communicate with my friends when I remember to check my messages, call people at 2 in the morning to talk about Doctor Who. And Chibnall's writing. Our Discord community has sections for literally anything you want to talk about. Cooking and food? Check. Memes? Check. General conversation? Check. Grandma's coming around to the house and your carpet is covered in peanut butter and honey, and you just want to know which cleaner would help but didn't expect to be asked why you have so much peanut butter and honey on the carpet, and now you come to the shocking realization you haven't bought peanut butter or honey in the last 2 years, and now you're needing to ask someone why they, you know, what they do if they start noticing the mole people living in their walls? Check. I have no segue to get out of that ridiculous list, so I'm going to jump into Twitter before your brains can comprehend the mole people living inside your walls. So Twitter. Wonderful Twitter. Problemless Twitter. Immaculate Twitter. No, seriously, I found that Twitter is a great place for public communication to complete strangers, much like Facebook, but without the possibility of having to talk to your great Uncle Henry about the latest image you've shared and how much he judges you for it. Now you could be judged by the whole world. All jokes aside, Twitter is a quick way to consume information fast and a great way to communicate with a community you've built, whether it's for a product or a service or just for something you connect to people with. In my case, I've got two accounts, a Twitter somewhat connected to my Twitch and a Twitter designed around my game development. For people who don't know, I've been making a video game for the past few years or so. These are never going anywhere. Because I'm on Twitter literally every single day, even for a few seconds out of the day, to check in with everyone, see what's going on in the world around me. Twitch! I have mentioned this a few times now, okay? And if you're someone who does not know, I am a Twitch affiliate. I stream 2 to 3 times a week, basically doing what I enjoy and having a good time with people around the world. I now have friends in England, I now have friends in Japan, in Australia, in Canada, and so many other more places, and thus have a better understanding of more of this happening on this little tiny rock floating in space that we call home. And a stronger appreciation for literally everywhere else that isn't my own country. Which is one of those places that I'm just never afraid to be myself. Great place for inspiration and interconnected communities. And let me tell you, the community I've built on there over the past couple of years, I couldn't be more proud of. I'm sticking on there for a long time, maybe not forever, but I'm not going anywhere anytime soon. Because quite frankly, when was the last time you heard anything bad happening over at Twitch? Instagram. For people who don't know, I do have an Instagram account. I actually have two. I have one with, which is basically, oh no, wait, no, I have three. Sorry, I have three. I have one account that is my main Instagram account, where I post pictures of myself, the family, random screenshots of what I'm working on during the day, food, a lot of food cooked. There's another one for gaming screenshots, which I haven't posted on in ages. And there's a new one that's more or less connected to my Twitch side of things that also posts screenshots of games that I also haven't posted on in ages. So there's that. I originally was going to leave Instagram, but I feel like this could be a good way to balance out leaving Facebook. I have plenty of friends and family that are on both websites. That don't really have the other ones, like I said before, like Discord, Twitch, Twitter, etc. And I feel like this would be a good way to continue keeping tabs with friends and family and seeing how their lives are going. That way I'm just not 100% out of the loop. I still have a way to communicate with people who, you know, aren't on these other sites. But yeah, I'd like to keep an eye on things, just from a distance. And for those of you who are worried about losing communication with me, do not worry. I do dabble in this little thing called old-fashioned communication, right? Calling people on the phone, sending texts, sending letters, postcards, telegrams, smoke signals, yelling really loudly while standing on a rooftop, and of course, YouTube. Because I can sit here and create some content here and there that might help people out, might inspire some people, might be able to share some creativity, and even if it's just one person, I like those odds. So I'm gonna stick around on YouTube. Plus, not only that, I also heavily consume videos on a day-to-day basis, so it's my form of entertainment as well. I ain't going anywhere off of YouTube anytime soon. I am going to be deleting one YouTube account that I know of, and the other one I am going to keep on just for the sake of my own YouTube history. Back before high school, I actually made GMVs. I was known back in the day as, what was it? God, I can't think of it. Destiny Islands 94. Oh my god, throwback. I used to be known as Destiny Islands 94. I had 60 subscribers. And even some of these videos didn't have the best of stuff, but hey, you know, this was back in the day. And, yeah, most of it was Kingdom Hearts related. A lot of it was cringy. But I had people that were generally on there quite a bit. And this 14 years ago, sweet baby Jesus. Wait, hold on. Where's my fan? I know I had a... I had a fan. Where is she? There she is. Sora X Girl right there. This person right here, I will never, ever abandon. This person right here is freaking amazing. So, Sora X Girl, shout out to Sora X Girl, who is still working on stuff. Sweet Bippy. Oh, I'm proud of you. Good on you. Look at that. She's still working on stuff. I am very proud of her. But she was my number one fan back in the day. I remember literally I had a fan. And this was her, Sora X Girl. I believe she went under a different name back in the day. She's changed her name. It was still Sora something or other. Oh, there it is. Yeah. XX Sora Girl 99XX. This was her. But yeah, I still have that. So I'm not going to delete that account simply because it is a strong part of my history. This is where I started on YouTube. And while I am 99% sure I am never returning back to that account, I am still going to leave it online. There's a couple like work in progress video YouTube accounts that I made as well. Those are probably going to skedaddle because I have no need for them. And like I said, there is one more YouTube account coming along very, very soon. It'll be under wraps for just a bit longer. Expect a formal announcement about that soon. Other than that, I think I'm done with the public scene. I've found the places I want to be, essentially. I've found the places I want to be at, so I don't see the point of having so many other places that I'm just simply not going to be at, you know? I don't see the point of being in places that I either have to force myself to actively be on, or just simply, I just never go on. I can't say it any other way. So, moving forward, I will be going through all of my email accounts that I have. I'm going to be deleting every account that I can find that I have not used in over 2 years. That's the first step. The first step is to go through every account that I have had, and if I have not visited that account, if I have not logged in for 2 years on a particular account connected to any of my emails, they're being shut down for good. You know what? I'm going to enjoy every second of it. Because here's the thing. It isn't just about deleting these accounts. Some of you might see this as just me leaving Facebook or me leaving another place. There is a much bigger part to this. There's a much bigger behind the scenes thing that you're not seeing. This is about looking back at who I used to be. This is about history. This is about me and who I used to be. This is about my past. What I used to laugh at, what I used to cry at, what made me back in the day. All the good things, all the bad things, all the cringe things. Reflect on what I needed in my life back then and compare it to what I need now. What I need now and what I can really do without, if I'm being honest. Shrink down those notifications to kind of just, a much smaller amount, you know? Just enjoy a little bit more peace, especially when it's so much harder to find it nowadays. And instead of waking up and looking about like 30 plus notifications on my phone, I kind of want to do that old-fashioned idea of waking up, making some coffee, and just sitting outside, just breathing in the nice chill air and just kind of doing what my grandparents did when they woke up, you know? I remember growing up, my grandfather would wake up at like 5 in the morning and he would grab the newspaper, he'd come inside and he'd sit down with a coffee and a small box of donuts, Hostess donuts. and I'd be sitting right along with him, with my own stack of newspaper and chocolate milk instead of coffee. And my grandmother, when she would wake up, she would go outside with a cigarette. She'd be at the back porch, or she'd be out in the front yard, and she would sit down, and she just... I remember going outside, and she would just be looking. Not talking to anyone on the phone, not scrolling through anything, not talking to anyone. She literally stood out there and looked. And not a lot of us do that anymore. Not a lot of us just look. I want to do that. I might make a video on this whole ordeal. I might make a video based off of, you know, going through these accounts and reliving old memories and deleting stuff from my history. I think it might be kind of fun to turn something mundane into entertainment, especially since I don't really see a lot of people ever doing this. Of course, I'll be taking the necessary precautions along the way, such as blurring out names and emails, addresses, and numbers, and all that good stuff so no one gets doxxed. But at the same time, most of these emails are going to be company stuff anyway, so it's going to be a whole bunch of, like, Game Jolts and McDonald's. You now have 20% off your Oculus Rift purchase for the next 3 days kind of things, and expired Domino's coupons. And, you know, just remember, okay, this isn't something I'm being forced to do. This isn't something that I've been dared to do. This isn't me running away from a mafia hitman or something like that. I'm not having a midlife crisis at 28 years old. I'm simply finally realizing what I need in my life and what I don't need in my life. I don't want to, I want to do more than just scroll mindlessly through things and instead of, you know, working on projects. You know, I actually want to finish projects, not be just distracted by a bunch of YouTube shorts and Facebook stories. I want to just solidify the core of who I am and minimize all the stuff that I just don't need in my life. Like I said, I'm 28. I've got plenty of time in the future, which is a good strong point to make here. I've got a lot of time on this earth, theoretically. I have a lot of time on this earth. What am I going to be spending that time on? You know, surely it's not going to be, you know, scrolling through, I don't know, Arby's coupons and my review for a restaurant 3 years ago is gaining traction on Google Maps. I have no interest in this, and I don't have the time for it. I want to use my time wisely. But yeah, I just wanted to give you a heads up. There's plenty of news I have coming up for all of you, from future streams to the status of my game development, family stuff, friend stuff, the usual stuff, really. More desserts, more lunches and dinners I'm experimenting with, and really just fun new stuff, so keep an eye out for that. I left this part pretty much for last here. Facebook is going to be the first one to go on this list. So this video should be shared on my page the day the gears begin spinning, as it were. Hopefully this will be out in December. And I believe I have the plan to shut things down starting January. I believe January should be the time things really start kicking off. Plenty of time to get in touch with everyone, so don't worry. I also have time to transfer old photos, memories, stuff like that. Anyways, that's all I've got to say for now. It runs in my family to kind of say goodbye for an hour as you inch slightly closer to the door. So I'll have to cut this here, or else this video turns into a mini documentary. So you all have a good one. Thanks for watching. I hope this finds you in good health. And yeah. That's all I had to say. Bye for now.